Okay, today I wanted something quick and we're running out of groceries. I got a few eggs left, things like that. I'm out of milk, so I'm kind of doing with what I have here to make a dessert. And I'm going to make a quick coffee cake, cinnamon coffee cake. So I've made, I had some powdered milk on hand, so I made a cup of milk. And you need oil for this. You need vanilla, you need cinnamon, salt. I use this real salt, sea salt that's embedded in the ground. Sounds weird, but you can look it up. Rumford aluminum-free baking powder. Try to get it without aluminum. Aluminum is very bad for your health. Sugar. Sugar isn't good for you either, but you gotta have some, don't you? And I've got flour. So, I don't know if I mentioned brown sugar. I've got that. So, this is supposed to be a halfway easy, quick recipe. So, we'll see. I'm going to prepare a 9x13 cake pan by just greasing it a little bit on the bottom with some butter. Next, I'm going to get the oven heated up because I don't think this is going to take very long, to 350 degrees. So, get that warmed up. Okay, it says in a large mixing bowl, I've got a bunch of bowls out here, combine the milk, the oil, eggs, and vanilla. So, okay, we've got 1 cup of milk. If you have fresh milk, use fresh. I'm sure you could use substitutes like soy milk or something like that in this. 2 eggs, so I'm going to put this down for a minute, get the eggs in there. Okay, I've got the eggs in there. The eggs, the milk, 2 eggs, 1 cup of milk, and it calls for 1 cup of oil. I know that's a lot, but I don't make stuff like this too often. Use some type of light oil. Don't use olive oil because unless you have light, it's going to impart that olive-y taste to it. I think that's vegetable oil that I used. Well, calls for 1 teaspoon of vanilla. And then I'm going to whisk all that together. Try not to get my iPod wet. Alright, that looks like it's pretty good. Alright, let's see what's next. Okay, 1 cup of sugar. I've got this organic raw cane sugar. Use whatever, you know, white sugar you want. 1 cup. Yep, 1 cup. Okay, 1 cup of sugar. Shut that later. 3 cups of flour. I'm not one that measures exactly perfectly. That's 1. And that means my oven's preheated. There's 3 cups of flour in there. Okay, sugar, flour, baking powder, and salt. Baking powder, 3 teaspoons. There's 1. Two, three. Yeah, aluminum is contributing to Alzheimer's, they believe. One lady said she took aluminum out of her mother's diet, and she started reversing and going back to normal. You can find it in cans, pop cans, beer cans, anything that's got a can that's aluminum. Bisquick baking mix is full of aluminum, and I've written to the company a number of times requesting that they quit doing that, but so far they haven't. So I've purchased other brands. I think Jiffy, I think, is one that I get that is non-aluminum, and it's almost the same as Bisquick. So, or you can make your own Bisquick. Look it up online. But look for the aluminum-free, and a lot of places are carrying it now. If not, you can order it on Amazon. I've ordered it on Amazon already. Okay, so we got our flour, our sugar, and our baking powder in there. I'm going to get a spoon and stir that. Let's try to get that baking powder mixed through. I forgot the salt. Half a teaspoon of salt needs to go in this. So I'm going to stir it a little bit again, get that salt mixed through it. And I forgot to say at the beginning that I think I said brown sugar you need for the topping and cinnamon, but you also need a half a cup of margarine or butter. I don't use margarine anymore. Very, very rarely, unless I'm basting something or like a turkey or something. I use real butter and I get it unsalted. I'm going to put that into a coffee cup and melt that. So anyhow, I'm going to let you know that. And then in a little bowl, we're going to make the topping. Okay, it's 1.5 cups of brown sugar. And usually when they say an amount of brown sugar, you want to lightly pack it into the cup. I got to do this with 2 hands. And 2 teaspoons of cinnamon. I think I'm going to take my fingers and mix this up. This is your topping for it. Maybe not. I'll just use this. Looks like it's mixing pretty good. Smells really good. And I don't make sweets real often. I make cookie, like oatmeal cookies once in a while, something like that. And on our birthdays, I make a cake. But other than that, it's usually something like oatmeal cookies, something healthier. But I felt like doing something today, and I didn't have anything else to make, so thought this sounded easy, fairly easy, a few steps it looks like, but it should be really good. Okay, so you've got your 1.5 cups of brown sugar and 2 teaspoons cinnamon mixed, and that's your topping. I melted the butter already. It's 1/2 cup of butter, and next we're going to mix the flour in that into this liquid, a little bit at a time. So I put about 1/3 of it, I think, in this. I'm using this big whisk so that it doesn't stick in there and I can't get it out. And I'll probably eventually use a spoon to finish mixing this. Like I said, don't be afraid to experiment. I was out of milk, so I'm using powdered milk mixed up to make a cup. You can probably use almond milk, soy milk. Egg substitute, whatever that equals to. I don't have egg substitute here. But, you know, if that's what you're using and you don't use real eggs or whole eggs, use your egg substitute. Okay, I'm going to get a spoon. Okay, I mixed it up real good with the spoon. So I've got the butter melted, the oven's preheated, the pan's ready, got the topping ready, so we're ready to rock and roll. We're going to pour half this batter, which is the cake batter part, into the 9x13 pan. Top it with half the streusel, and then top with remaining batter and remaining streusel. Then pour your melted butter over it. So, I don't know if I can do this one-handed, but I'll try to do it. Probably end up dropping it. That looks like about half. Okay, stop dripping. Now I'm going to spread that with my big spoon. Okay, so I got half the batter spread in there. I'm going to top it with half of this topping. And don't be afraid to have globs in there, because I've made coffee cake before, and those little globs, if it's not even, are where it goes down and makes a real nice big gooey gooey part of brown sugar that's wonderful. So it doesn't have to be perfect. Okay, looks like about half the topping. And I'm going to finish that with that, and I'll show that to you. Okay, I topped it with the other half of the cake batter. And try to smooth it out a little bit on there. It's hard, though, because you got the other stuff underneath it. And then put the rest of your topping. Like I said, it doesn't have to be perfect. Have fun while you're cooking. And learn from whatever mistakes you make. I've learned a lot over the years. That's why I'm putting all these videos on, to try to help other people that are just learning how to cook. Not be afraid to do things, you know. Tell my husband to get some fresh milk on the way home. This would be a lot better. Powdered milk is all right, though, as long as you mix it up and stick it in the fridge. It doesn't taste bad at all. So, okay. So we got the topping on it. Now I'm going to drizzle it with the butter. Here we go. Fun part, drizzling the butter. You know, it might be easier in that cup. I'm going to put it in that cup. They're much easier. And I don't think you have to be perfect with this either. Do your own thing. Get every last drop of butter. There's still a little bit left in there. Okay, looks yummy. Nope, nothing else coming out of there. Okay, this goes in a 350 degree oven for 25 to 30 minutes. Okay, I put it on for 25. I always go a little bit less because it's better to have to add 5 minutes. You can't take 5 minutes off if you've overcooked it. So I go the shy, you know, the lower figure. So I'll show you this in 25 minutes. Okay, I just got it out of the oven. I did it 35 minutes total. And it looks just nice and golden. Look at that, it's beautiful. I took a toothpick and went into some of these drier areas like this right here. And see how it's firm when I touch it? Don't burn yourself, though. But you want it, Before, when I took it out of the oven, all this was jiggling like Jell-O still. So I knew it was still raw. I put a toothpick into some of these thicker areas, and it came out clean. So, and if you look at the bottom and sides of it, it's nice golden brown. It's not burnt. So 35 minutes total is what I did it. If your oven's hotter, though, you know, just keep an eye on it. It should look nice and golden like that. I'll show it to you later when we cut into it.